ओम शांति मॉर्निंग मुरली बाप दादा मधुबन 23/9/20 एसेंस स्वीट चिल्ड्रन द ओनली कंसर्न यू शुड हैव इज हाउ टू शो एवरीवन द पाथ टू द लैंड ऑफ हैप्पीनेस एवरीवन शुड नो दैट इज दिस इज द कन्फ्लुएंस एज इन विच यू बिकम द मोस्ट एलिवेटेड ह्यूमन बींग्स क्वेश्चन वेन डू यू चिल्ड्रन गिव कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशन टू वन अनदर When do human beings give congratulations to one another? Answer: Human beings give congratulations when someone is born, when someone is victorious on someone's wedding day, or on a special important day. However, those are not real congratulations. You children give one another congratulations for belonging to the father. You say. We are so fortunate that we have been liberated from all sorrow and that we will go to the land of happiness. You experience happiness in your hearts. Om Shanti. The unlimited father sits here and explains to the unlimited children the question now arises. Who is the unlimited father? You know that the father of all is the one who is called the Supreme Father. A physical father cannot be called the Supreme Father. There is only the one Supreme Father, and all the children have forgotten him. Therefore, you children understand how the Supreme Father, the Supreme Soul, who is the remover of sorrow and the bestower of happiness, is removing your sorrow, and that you will then go into peace and happiness. Not everyone will go into happiness. Some will remain in peace and others will go into happiness. Some play their parts from the golden age, some from the silver age, and others from the copper age. When you live in the golden age, everyone else will be in the land of liberation. That is called God's home. When the Muslims say their prayers, they all get together and pray to God, Khuda. What for? Is it to go to paradise or to go to God? Allah, God's home cannot be called paradise. Their souls stay in silence. There are no bodies there. You must know they will go to Allah with their bodies, but as souls. One cannot become pure just by remembering Allah without knowing Him. How can you advise people that the Father is giving everyone the inheritance of peace and happiness? How can you explain to them there can be the peace around the world when there was peace in the world? Serviceable children think about these things number wise according to the effort they make. The Father has only given you Brahmins, the mouth-born creation. His introduction, He has also told you about the parts that all the people of the world play. Now, how can we give people the introduction of the Father and the creations? The Father tells everyone, consider yourself to be a soul and remember me, and you will go to God's home. Not everyone will go to the golden age. There is only the one religion. All the rest are in the land of peace. There is no question of becoming upset about this. People ask for peace, but that can only be received in the home of Allah. God the Father, all souls come from the land of peace. Everyone will return there when the play comes to an end. The Father comes and takes everyone from the impure world back home. It is now in the intellects of you children that you are now to go to the land of peace, and that you will then go to the land of happiness. This is the most elevated confluence age. Elevated human beings means those who are the highest. focused on high beings. Until a soul becomes pure, he cannot become an elevated human being. The father now says, "Remember me and understand the world cycle and also imbibe divine virtues, and human beings are spoiled. In the new world, their characters are first class. It is the people of Bharat who become ones with elevated characters. Only you children understand this. How can you explain to others what easy method should you create to open the third eye of souls? The soul of Baba has knowledge. People say that they have knowledge, that is body consciousness. Here you have to become soul conscious. Sannyasis have knowledge of the scriptures. Explain this with tact. Those people consider Krishna to be God. They don't know God. Rishis and Munis used to say that they didn't know, but they did understand that human beings cannot be God. Only the incorporeal Father is the creator. But how does he create? What is his name? Land and time. They don't know. So they say that he is beyond name and form. They don't have enough sense to realize that there cannot be anything without a name or form. That is impossible. If they say that he is in the pebbles and stones or in a fish or a crocodile, that is a name and form. Sometimes they say one thing and at other times they say something else. You children should think a lot day and night about how to explain to people. This is the most elevated confluence age in which you become deities from ordinary humans. Human beings bow down to the idols of the deities. Human beings don't bow down to the idols of human beings. Human beings have to bow down to God or the deities. Muslims also pray to Allah. They remember Allah. You know that they would not be able to reach Allah. The main thing is how to reach Allah. How then does He create the new world? How does Allah create the new world? How can you explain all of these things? You children have to churn the ocean of knowledge for this. The Father doesn't have to churn the ocean of knowledge. The Father teaches you children the way to churn the ocean of knowledge. At this time, everyone in the Iron Age is Tamo Pradhan. There will definitely be the Golden Age. Sometimes, the Golden Age is said to be pure. There is purity and to be pure, there is purity and impurity. Alloy is mixed into gold. Souls too are pure. Sato Pradhan at first and then alloy is mixed into them. When souls have become Tamo Pradhan, the Father has to come. Only the Father comes and creates the Sato Pradhan land of happiness. There are only the peoples of Bharat in the land of happiness. All the rest remain in the land of peace. Everyone in the land of peace is pure. And then when they come down here, they very slowly continue to become impure. Every human being definitely goes through the stages of Sato, Rajo and Tamo. How can you tell everyone that they can all go to God's home? God speaks. Renounce all body relations and consider yourself to be souls. When you remember me, the five evil spirit, then the Father too is concerned about. And this is why he had the thought of coming here to make everyone happy. Along with that, you children have to become his helpers. What could the father do alone by himself? Therefore, churn this ocean of knowledge. What method should you create so that people can quickly understand that this people could quickly understand that this is the most elevated confluence age. It is only at this time that people can become most elevated. First, they fall and are elevated, and then they fall. They don't fall straight away. They don't become tamopradhan as soon as they come down. Everything is at first satopradhan, and then it goes through the stages of sato, rajo, and tamo. You children hold so many exhibitions, but in spite of that, people don't understand anything. Therefore, what other method should you create? You have to find different methods. You have been given time for this. No one can become complete and perfect instantly. The moon is too only becomes full gradually. We became tamopradhan gradually, and so it also takes time for us to become satopradhan. That is non-living and this is living. So how can we explain? You should explain to the mullahs, heads of the mosques, of the Muslims, why they pray, do namaz, and in whose remembrance they do it. You have to chant these things. President, etc., go to mosques on big and important days. They go and meet the senior people there. There are small mosques, and there is also one main mosque where they all go and give greetings for Eid. Now, greetings are to be given when all of us become liberated from all types of sorrow, and we then go to the land of happiness. We are giving you good news. When someone wins something, he is congratulated. Even when couples get married, they are given congratulations. May you always remain happy. The father has explained to you how you can give congratulations to one another. At this time, we are claiming our inheritance of liberation and liberation in life from the unlimited father. You can receive congratulations for this. The father says, congratulations to you. You are becoming multi-millionaires for 21 births. How can all the people claim their inheritance from the father, that they can be congratulated? You know all of this, but people cannot congratulate you. They don't know you. When they give you congratulations, they too can become worthy of receiving congratulations. You are incognito. You can congratulate each other. Congratulations. We now belong to the unlimited father. You are so fortunate when someone wins. You are so fortunate. When someone wins a lottery or a child is born in his family, he is congratulated. When a child passes his examination, he is congratulated. You have happiness deep in your hearts. You give congratulations to yourself. We have found the father from whom we receive our inheritance. The father explains, all of you souls went into degradation and are now receiving salvation. Everyone received the same congratulations at the end. Everyone will come to know. Those who are lower down will give congratulations to those who are highest on high. You become the emperors and empress of the Sun Dynasty clan. Those who are lower in the clan will give congratulations to those who become beads of the rosary of victory. Those who pass will be congratulated. They will be worshipped. Congratulations will be given to the souls who receive a high status. Those souls will then be worshipped on the path of devotion. People don't know why they worship them. Therefore, the only concern you children should have is how to explain to others. We have become pure, so now can we make others pure? The world is huge. What should we do so that the message can reach every home? When leaflets are dropped, not everyone will receive them. Each one has to have the message put into his hands because no one knows at all how to reach the Father. They say that all paths lead to God. However, the Father says, you have been worshipping and making donations and performing charity for birth after birth, and yet you didn't find the path. They say that all of that has continued eternally. But when did it begin? They don't understand the meaning of eternally. But when did it begin? You too understand number wise according to the efforts you reward of knowledge, which is happiness, and then there is sorrow. The accounts of those who have done the most devotion are explained to you children. Not all of these details can be explained to each one individually. What should we do? Print it in the papers. That would take time. Not everyone will receive the message that quickly. If everyone began to make effort, all of them would then go to heaven. It cannot be like that. You are now making effort for heaven. How can we make those who belong to our religion emerge again? How can you know who has been transferred? Who know those who believe in the Hindu religion belong originally to the deity religion? No one even knows. Those who are staunch Hindus will believe in their original eternal deity religion. At this time, all are impure. They call out, O purifier, come. They call out to the incorporeal one to come and take them to the pure world. How did they claim such a huge kingdom? There is no kingdom in Bharat at this time which they would have defeated and claimed. They don't attain their kingdom by battling. No one human knows how ordinary human beings can be made into deities. You have now begun to know this. From the Father, how can we tell this to others so that they can attain liberation and liberation in life? There has to be someone who has inspired them to make effort so that they can know themselves and remember Allah. Ask them, to whom do you give congratulation at the time of Eid? Do you have the firm faith that you are going to Allah? You have so much happiness in that. You have been doing that for many years. You become confused as to whether you will never go to God or not. This world cannot be called heaven. All souls are impure. How can they become pure so that they go to the home of Allah? Vicious souls don't exist there. They have to be wiseless. Souls do not become satopradhan immediately. All of these things are to be thought about and of knowledge, and this is how he is able to explain to you. You too should create ways to explain to others. You become faith that you are going to Allah, you have so much happiness in that you have been doing that for many years. Achha, to the sweetest beloved, long lost and now found children, love, remembrance and good morning from the mother, the father, Bab Dada and the spiritual father says, Namaste to the spiritual children. Essence for Dharna. The father had the thought to come here and liberate the children from their sorrow and make them happy. You have to become the father's helpers in the same way. You have to become the father's helper in the same way. You should also think of ways of enabling the message to reach every home. Two, in order to receive congratulations from everyone, make effort to become a bead of the rosary of victory. Become worthy of worship. Blessing. May you be a special server who reveals the Father with a balance of humility and authority. When there is a balance, wonders are visible. When you give anyone the Father's introduction with a balance of humility and authority, wonders will be visible. You have to glorify the Father in this way. Let your words be clear and filled with love, humility and sweetness, as well as with greatness and truth. And revelation will then take place. In between speaking, continues to give them experience through which they will feel themselves to be lost in love. Those who serve in this way are special servers. Slogan. Even if you do not have any facilities at a time of need, do not let any obstacles stop your spiritual endeavor. Om Shanti.